So hello and welcome students, this is your accounts teacher Saurabh Pradhan. In the last session we have discussed the method of preparing capital accounts of partner, that is with the help of fixed capital method and with the help of fluctuating capital method. In this session we are going to discuss a question based on that. Fine, so here is the question right on the screen. Okay, so quickly take the screenshot of that. Fine, so this is the entire body of question. Okay, and this is your answer here also. Fine, now let us quickly proceed with the solution. Okay, so as you can see I have already prepared the table. So let us start with preparation of profit and loss appropriation account first. Okay, so profit and loss appropriation account. Okay, this is debit side, this is credit side. Fine, so in the question it is given that the profit was 67,500. So where do we start from? We start from writing the profit on the credit side by profit and loss account. Okay, that is 67,500. Fine, now interest on capital is mentioned and the capitals of partners are also mentioned, that is 1 lakh and 80,000 respectively. So now let us quickly calculate interest on capital. To interest on capital count, fine, to P and to Q. Okay, now let me show you how to calculate that. Okay, so for P, okay, for P it is rupees 1 lakh. Okay, it is rupees 1 lakh. 1 lakh at the rate 9%. What you will get? You will get rupees 9,000. Okay, and for Q, okay, and for Q it is rupees 80,000 at the rate 9%. Fine. What you will get? You will get 7,200. Fine. So now let's put that particular amount in our profit and loss appropriation account. Fine. So we have calculated 9,000 for P and 7,200 for Q. If you will total it, you will get 16,200. Now the next is P's salary. Now P's salary is given 1,000 per month. Okay, so if you multiply it by 12, you will get rupees 12,000. Okay, to salary account. Fine, that is P's salary. Okay, P's salary. So that is rupees 1,000 at the rate 12 months. You will get 12,000 here. Fine. Now the next one is Q's commission. Now Q is given commission of rupees 10,000. Fine. So again it will be represented here to commission. Okay. That is 10,000. And to whom we are giving commission? To Q. Fine. Now the next is drawings. So we are interested in interest on drawing, okay, because it is a profit and loss appropriation account and interest on drawing is gain for the firm. So it will be represented on the credit side of the profit and loss appropriation account. Now by interest on drawing account, fine, to P and to Q. For P it is 400 and for Q it is 300. Now the total is 700. Fine. Now we have almost completed our profit and loss appropriation account. Now let's quickly balance it out. So if you will see, if you will add the debt, if you will add the credit side of the account, you will find out that it is 68,500. Fine. It is 68,500. Okay. Sorry, 68,200. That is 68,200. Fine. And if you will add the total of the debit side, you will find that is equivalent to 38,200. Fine. 38,200. Now the balance remained is 30,000. The balance remained is rupees 30,000. Now let's first of all check that if there is any profit sharing ratio mentioned or not. So in the question, I can see that there is no profit sharing ratio mentioned. Fine. So in the case, the profit sharing ratio is not mentioned, the profits are distributed equally. So that 30,000 will be distributed between P and Q equally. Fine. So if you will divide 30,000 by 2, you will get 15,000. Fine. And this 15,000 is for Q as well as for P. Okay. Now suppose if there were three partners and three partners would have distributed that particular profit, okay, equally, then 30,000 would have been divided by 3. Fine. In this case, since there are two partners and they are distributing the profit equally, so it has been divided by 2. Now this 15,000 is for P and for Q as well. So 2 profit transferred, okay, 2 profit transferred. Fine. Let us increase that size of the table a little bit. Now, for P and for Q, both are getting the equal amount. Fine. Why both are getting the equal amount? Because no PSR is mentioned. In the absence of PSR, that will be the divisible profit will be always distributed equally. And also remember that this balance is always known as divisible profit. Okay. Okay, the profit left after all the appropriations are known as divisible profits. That is 30,000. Now, if you will total it, you will again get the balance. That is there on credit side. That is 68,200. Fine. Now we have to prepare now the fixed capital account of partner. So, under fixed capital account method, the partners of the capital doesn't change, okay? So, you have to prepare two separate account. One is partner's capital account and another is partner's current account, fine? So, this is partner's fixed capital account, fine? So, this is A part of the question, fine? So, let's write down the capital quickly. By balance brought down, for P it is rupees 1 lakh and for Q it is 80,000. Fine. Now let's balance it. Fine. See, there are drawings given, but as you know, the drawings, it is not mentioned here whether the drawings has been made out of profits or it has been made out of capital. So in that case, it is always assumed that the drawings is made out of profits. Fine. So that's why it is not shown in the partner's fixed capital account. Fine. That is partner's fixed capital accounts, which means that the partner's capital will not change. But it will be shown somewhere, and the account in which it will be reflected is known as partner's current account. Fine. That is partner's current account. Now, let's check whether there is any current account balance. So, there is no current account balance mentioned here. Okay. So, we will directly start with interest on capital. By interest on capital account. So what was the interest? As we have calculated, the interest for P was 9,000 and for Q it was 7,200. Fine. Okay. Similarly, salary. Now this salary is only paid to P. Okay. It is 1,000 per month. So accordingly, it will be 12,000 for a year. The next is commission. So by commission. Commission is paid to whom? Commission is paid to Q. That is rupees 10,000. Fine. Yes. Now the drawings. Two drawings. The drawings of P is rupees 6,000 and for Q it is rupees 5,000. Fine. Now, the interest on drawings, the last item, that is 400 for P and 300 for Q. Fine. So I assume that almost all the items apart from the divisible profit is mentioned here. Fine. Now let us also put in the divisible profit there. So what was the divisible profit? Divisible profit was rupees 15,000. Right? And it is coming from profit and loss appropriation account. So to profit and loss appropriation account. Right? Rupees 15,000. Fine. So your partner's current account is almost prepared. Only balancing is left. Okay. Now let's quickly balance the accounts. Okay. It is quite clear that the credit side of partner's current account is bigger than the partner's debit side of the account. Okay. So if you will total it, what you will get? You will get 36,000 here. Okay. And if you total the column of Q, you will get 32,200. Fine. That is 32,200. Okay. Now, let's quickly balance the account. Now, 36,000 minus 6,400. Okay. That will be the total for P. What you will get? 36,000 minus 6,400. Okay. You will get 29,600. Fine. Similarly for Q, that is 32,200, and you have to deduct 5,300 from there. Okay. What you will get? You will get 26,900 as your balance. Right. So your partner's current account is also completed here. Okay. Okay. So with the help of fixed capital method, we have seen how to prepare the account. Okay. Since there was no opening capital in the partner's current account, so no opening capital balance is mentioned here. If suppose the current account opening balance is given, then you have to first of all mention that balance, and then you have to put the remaining items in your partner's current account. Now, this is the B part of the question, that is fluctuating capital account. Fine. Now, in this case, the capital is also mentioned. Fine. The capital is also mentioned. Why? Because in fluctuating capital account method, we assume that the partner's capital will change. Okay. Will change accordingly. If there are profits, then profit will be added in the capital. If there are losses, then it will be deducted from the capital, and it will keep changing like that. Fine. So that is also called partner's capital account. Fine. Now, first of all, let's put the balance there. By balance brought down, that is 1 lakh for rupees P and 80,000 for rupees Q. Okay. Interest on capital. Interest on capital is rupees 9,000, and for Q it is 7,200. Fine. Similarly, salary. Now salary is only paid to P, and that was rupees 12,000. Okay. Commission. Commission is paid to Q, rupees 10,000. Okay. And now the last is the balance of profit and loss appropriation account. Fine. Okay, so we have already calculated the divisible profit, that were 15,000 for each of the partners. Fine. Okay. Now let's also see the debit side entries. The debit side entry is only drawings and interest on drawings, fine. So to interest on drawing account, interest on drawing, or first of all let's write drawing and then interest on drawing. To drawings account, that is ₹6,000 and ₹5,000 for Q. Okay. To interest on drawing account. Okay. That is 400 for P and 300 for Q. Okay. Now almost all the data has been transferred in the partner's capital account also. As you can see that we have just copy pasted all the items that we have there in our profit and loss appropriation account. Okay. All these items that were on the debit side of profit and loss appropriation account has been directly posted to the credit side of partner's capital account in both the cases. Okay. In both the cases, whether it is the case of fixed capital method or it is the case of fluctuating capital method. Fine. In case of fixed capital method, it is posted on the credit side of partner's current account, and in the case of fluctuating capital method, it is posted on the credit side of partner's capital account. Okay. So that is the only difference. This is in fluctuating case, it is partner's capital account, and in the fixed case, it is partner's current account. Fine. Now let us balance that out. The last step. Okay. The last step. Now let's quickly total the amount. For P it will be 36,000 plus 1,36,000. Okay. For Q it will be 32,200 plus 80,000. That will be 1,12,200. Fine. 1,12,200. Now let's deduct the debit side from that. So for P, 1,36,000 minus 6,400. Okay. What you will get? You will get 1,29,600 for P. So to balance, carry it down. 1,29,600 for P, and similarly for Q, 1,12,200 minus 5,300. Fine. What you will get? 9 is 6. Okay, that is 0. That is 1. 1,06,900. Fine. So that is the balance for partners' capital account in the case the partners' capitals are fluctuating. Fine. Now let's total that. The total will be equal to the credit side. 1,36,000 and 1,12,200. Fine. So this is the complete solution. Okay. I will scroll the profit and loss appropriation account for you so that you can see the entire solution. Okay. So that is profit and loss appropriation account. Fine. That is partner's capital account. Fine. That is partner's current account. And this is the B part of the question. Okay. And this has been prepared with the help of fluctuating capital method. Okay. So this is the complete solution. Okay. So I hope you liked the video. Okay. And again, the same information I want to give to you. So if you are interested in joining our courses, okay, so kindly contact us on the number that is given there. Okay. I'm writing down the number 9415614156. Okay. You can call on that number or you can WhatsApp for joining our online or offline courses. Okay. Thanks for watching the video.